Hey, I'm redoing the video that I did yesterday. Hopefully you all can see me. I'm laying in bed. And I've had some coffee, so I'm shaking. So, anyways, I wanted to talk to you guys about something that's weighing on my mind. And I know I'm probably not the only one. And it's just, you know, you go in for your regular test, not having to, well, you go in for your regular test having to do with our illness, and nothing ever shows up except for vitamin D deficiency, and then you go in for your regular test if you're like me, you're at high risk for cancer, breast cancer and everything. So you go religiously to your appointments, even though you dread them, and every time that a test comes out abnormal and you've got to go back for the second one, you're always feeling like in the back of your mind, I'm on borrowed time. I feel like I'm on borrowed time, even though you're going, oh, I've had these before and they always come out fine. But those of us that are at high risk, it's like, how many times is this going to happen before it's not just a drill, before it's the real thing? And I've grown attached to my breasts. I don't want to lose them. I'm not so worried about losing my life. It's just, I mean, my other test with my illness that makes me sick every day, I mean, we don't find anything on those. But the other ones that you want to turn out normal, then every once in a while they don't. And it causes you stress. So, I'm not meaning to whine about it. I'm just being honest. I mean, and I'm not the only one. I mean, there's a whole bunch of us, and it's like, geez, it's like we're defective or something, you know. It's amazing that we survived birth, you know. But, why can't the tests for my illness be the ones that come out abnormal? And, I mean, and if all these studies were true about tea and coffee, I wouldn't have tests come out abnormal when it comes to cancer stuff, because I drink a lot of green tea. I drink a lot of tea, you know, herbal and green and not as much black, but, I mean, so, I don't know. I just wanted to ask you guys if you have the same stuff going on, and it's just this, anyone who says, oh, I never worry about it, they've got to be lying, because how do you not stress when in the back of your mind, I'm the oldest person in my family who has both breasts and a uterus. I mean, come on. I don't know. So, it just gets old, because it's like, you know what I'm saying, don't you? I mean, you guys write me and let me know if you have the same feeling. I mean, it's like, so I go back on, I lost my, what I wanted to say there, but I go back on January 20th and get another mammogram. It's the left side, they say, has changed. Which can mean nothing or it can mean everything. And so when I go back, they will read them right there, they say, while I'm there, and have the ultrasound too. So they'll do the mammogram and the ultrasound on the left side again. Which I've had that done before. You know, this is my second time of having to go back. And 3 years or is it 6 years? I don't know. It all becomes a blur because you try not to think about it. I get tempted to not go at all to my mammograms. But then how stupid would that be if I lost my life and I knew better? So, anyways, alright, I just thought I'd make a video about it. So if anybody else is feeling the same way, they know that there's a whole bunch of us out there, and it's frustrating, and I just figured that I would open the forum up and talk about it, and if, you know, if people are going to judge us for being honest, then they aren't worth our time. To be honest with you, if people judge me for what I put out there, I'll just block them, so, because mostly what I get when I'm being honest is I get people thanking me, telling me, oh, it's so good to know I'm not alone. And I know I look lovely once again. All this came to my mind while I was soaking in the hot tub because I've been freezing this morning. So, yep. So here I am with my wet hair laying in bed with all this on my mind. So I just thought I'd put it on video on my vlog. So so we could discuss it if anybody wants to. Alright, I'll kick myself out of this. I'm feeling kind of blue. We have the inversion. I'll kick myself out of this mood eventually, but see you later. Bye.